wonderful. Hi everyone, my name is Mridul and welcome back to my channel and welcome to another day in my life. The last one that I filmed was quite a few months ago and I've been getting quite a lot of requests from you guys to film another one. And of course it's lockdown 2.0, so all of us are staying at home. I'm right now at my parents' place and I've actually been at my nanny's place for a week and today's a Monday. So I came back yesterday, Sunday ko, to film a bunch of videos today and then I'm gonna be going back to my nanny's place tomorrow because I've just been like trying to spend time with them. So it is 7:30 right now and I'm just having some breakfast. I'm having some leftover pasta from last night. I swear this tastes so much better like the next day. Did I tell you what time it is? It's 7:30 right now. I've woken up really, really early because there's so much that I need to get done today. I have to film, I think, like 3 videos for the coming week. So that I can edit them when I'm at my nanny's place. And also in today's vlog, I'm gonna be sharing with you guys some things that make me happy. I know it's been a dark time for all of us, so I just made a list on my phone and I'm gonna be sharing with you guys everything throughout the vlog that kind of lightens up my mood and brings a smile on my face. So the first thing is that I've been making a list on my phone. It's titled Things to Do After Lockdown. So I just write down everything that comes mere dimag mein that I want to do after the lockdown ends. Now, if doing this makes you upset, then obviously don't do it. But for me, I feel like I feel positive and I feel like there's a ray of light on the other side of the tunnel almost. So I like to do this. So the first thing that I've written down is eat pani puri. I don't even remember the last time I had pani puri. So I was really craving it the other day. So I wrote it down here. Then the next one is really random. It is to get a professional photo shoot done. I have never really gotten a professional photo shoot done ever, so I really want to do that. Other than that, I want to get a tattoo, I want to get a piercing. Other than that, I also need to get my cervical cancer ka shot, which is obviously really important, but I can only do that after lockdown. So those are some of the things that I've added to my list. I really want to know what is on your list, so please let me know. I'm just gonna go and finish up my breakfast. After that, I have to go make some lunch. So as I mentioned earlier, the whole of last week I was at my nanny's place, so my mom had to make both lunch and dinner for the whole week. So I'm going to try to make lunch today and also going to try to make dinner. Let's see how both the things go, but abhi ke liye I'm gonna go make lunch. So when I was actually at my nanny's place, I learned properly how to make rotis, like properly kaise aata gunte hai, kaise roti belte and then pakate. So I think I've gotten really good at that, so I'm gonna do that. And also I've learned quite a lot of sabzi ke recipes also from my nani. So I'm gonna try to make her famous bhindi. Sorry, excuse my phone. I love her bhindi, so I'm going to try to make it. And yeah, roti banana, I think that's basically it. Shouldn't take me that long. My target is by 10 I need to start filming, so I need to hurry up and finish this and then we can get on with cooking. Done making lunch. Haven't had it yet because it's too early to have lunch. Also did my makeup. I'm ready to film, but before I start filming, I thought I would sit down with you guys and share some of my favorite books with you guys, because you guys have been asking me for my favorite book recommendations and this is definitely something that has been helping me out a lot during this lockdown. I think it's been a solid 2 years since I haven't read, and I'm finally back to reading. I hope it stays the same. But I'll share with you guys some of my favorite books. So I'm gonna start with 3 books which are very, very easy to read. Like, you're not gonna have to pull out the dictionary to figure out what the words mean in here. It's a very easy read. These necessarily will not have something valuable that you'll take away. These are like stories, like fiction books, and they're very easy to read. Lots of drama and like gossip in here. But I think these books are great if you're trying to like start reading. You need something that's like interesting, that's going to pull you in. So these are my top recommendations for that. The first one is called Click. It's the Click series and all of their books are so nice. It's very like high school teenage drama, but it's fun. The next book that I have is called The Backbenchers. This is by Siddharth Oberoi. So this is something that I read when I was in like 8th or 9th standard. So if you're young, I think you'll really enjoy it. And I used to recommend this book to a lot of people when I was younger, and everyone seemed to love this book. It's very like fun and juicy. Then we have Two States by Chetan Bhagat. I think I personally like the book more than the movie. If you like the movie, you're gonna love this book. So those three books are gonna be extremely easy reads. You're not gonna need to use your brain for it, but it's going to like pull you in and it's gonna make it interesting. Now, talking about a few more books which will like have something for you to take away as well. The first book, I always recommend these two. The first one is called Girl Boss, and this is very motivational, very positive. It almost like lights a fire and it just makes you want to do stuff. So it's a very, very good book. Also, I will say this is a very easy read as well. Then we have The Palace of Illusions. I think this is my number one favorite book. This is based on Draupadi and the Pandava brothers, but you don't need to necessarily like mythology to like this book, because before this I wasn't really into all of that. But this book, it's just so well written. Not the easiest to read, just a little bit difficult than the previous ones that I shared with you guys, but it's so worth it. It's such a nice book. Again, a book that I've recommended to so many people and they always tend to love this book. Then we have books by Jean Sasson. I actually own quite a few books, and I've ordered all the other ones that I don't own from Amazon. So the first book that I ever read was called Princess. So basically, this is based on a true story of a Saudi Arabia princess, basically a look into the royal family, and it's so interesting. Most of these books are on those lines. It's so fascinating for me personally, and I think these are very easy reads. I would say definitely pick Princess up. If you are able to go through Princess, you can start buying the others and start reading those. The next book that I want to recommend, I could not find the copy for some reason, which makes me very sad, because I remember I used to read that book when I was in 10th standard. It's a very, very thick book. The second half of 10th standard, I should have been studying, but I was reading that book. And that book is very sad. Like, I remember I was just bawling half of the time when I was reading that book, and the other half I was smiling like from the inside. It's just such a beautiful book. It's a very lengthy book for sure, but I feel like if you have the time, definitely pick it up. It's gonna make you cry, it's gonna make you smile. And the next book that I have is called The Secret. This is just such a classic. It took me so long to read this book, I don't know why, but it's just such a nice book. And I think everyone should read this. Very easy read. Again, I read the whole book in a day, and it's very insightful. Like, there is a lot written about gratitude, visualization, manifestation, vision boards. It's a magical book. You must read this. So yeah, those were some of my recommendations. I will link all the books that I spoke about in the description box below in case you want to buy them. But now I'm gonna go and start filming, or maybe I should have lunch before that. Yeah, I think I'll have lunch, and let me actually do a taste test for you guys. So, side note, my mom and I spent like half an hour. I, mummy, uske pehle, I spent another half an hour trying to find the charger of my DSLR. And finally, mummy aayi, aur uske baad we found it in the very spot where I knew it was, but somehow I could not see it there. But yeah, the point of the story is that I found my charger so I can finally start filming. But I wasted 1 hour of my precious day trying to find a charger. Okay, so here we have my lunch. We have two rotis, then we have the sabzi, bhindi ki sabzi, and dal. This dal is made by my mom. My mom makes the yummiest dal. So let's do a quick taste test. Also, excuse the mess in the background. And also, if you can hear my dad screaming, it's because he's taking his lecture, Zoom lecture. The roti is actually not papad today, so that's good. Most definitely doesn't taste like my nani's bhindi. But it's not bad. I can eat it. Pretty edible. Okay, so I'm quickly going to get done with my lunch because I'm running really late. I was supposed to start filming at, I think, 10. It's close to 12 at this point. So, yeah, need to get started. So I just got done filming one video. I completely forgot to show you my nails, actually. So I did these neon nails, stick-on nails, of course. I got these from Shein, in case you guys are wondering. I got this like a year ago, and I've been just storing them, and I finally used them. They actually look really nice. But I'm just gonna take a small break, have some mangoes. Yahan pe pade hain mangoes. So I'm just gonna have those. And what else am I gonna do? I'm gonna have a big glass of hot water because that is such a must-have when I'm filming. I try to at least drink one cup of full hot water in between each video. And also another necessity is my planner. Need to have my planner when I'm filming because I like write everything down, my to-do list, and it just makes everything easy. Got done with another video. Also, I shot in front of this beautiful backdrop. I had to stand and shoot because ye kafi height pe hai. Usually I sit down and shoot, but I had to stand up for this to be visible in the backdrop. So it is 7 o'clock and I'm finally done with filming. As you can see, it's such a mess. Actually, I do need to take a few close-ups. This is not a very flattering angle, but I've gotten the worst cramp in my leg. Like whenever I sit down on the floor to film, I always get a cramp on like one of my legs, and I can't feel my leg right now, so I have to lie down. So abhi main kya karne wali hu, close-ups lungi, just get it out of the way, and then I'll clean, and then I'll show you another thing that I do to kind of cheer myself up and just liven up the mood during lockdown. So before I'm able to build up the courage to clean this mess, I'm gonna have some coffee. I definitely know it's a mental thing because I haven't had coffee since like 3 weeks at this point, and I've been doing fine. Like there hasn't been like a dip in energy or anything like that. I think it's just the taste that I've been craving a lot, and I feel like I've had a long day. I deserve it. I've been trying to cut back because there's so much sugar in this coffee that I'm having. I could maybe like switch to black coffee, but then usme maza hi kya hai. So anyway, I'm just gonna enjoy my cup of coffee, clean. Oh my god, that's like the part that I dread when it comes to filming. I wish I had some help who would like come in and just clean my room for me. Yeah, that's never gonna happen. So I'm just gonna go and clean up, and I'll catch you after I'm done cleaning. So I'm finally done with cleaning. It actually took me just 15 minutes to clean, which is great for me. Now, the next thing that I like to do is indulge in some self-care. I love self-care. I made so many videos about like self-care and pampering routines last year, and I think it still applies till date. Whenever I'm feeling low, I will always do like a nice chumpy and do a face mask, and it really makes me feel nice. I don't know what it is about self-care and pampering. It just always makes me feel good. And especially when you get a chumpy done by someone else, like when you don't have to apply the oil yourself, it's the best. So last week, as I mentioned earlier, I was at my nanny's place and I carried with me the onion range from Mama Earth. So this is their new and improved onion range. You guys already know that I love the onion shampoo and the hair mask as well. So when I heard that they have come out with a new formula, I was excited. So let's start off by talking about the hair oil. So the onion hair oil has onion oil and Redensil in it. So onion, we all know, is great to kind of manage and tame down hair fall. So recently Mama Earth came out with their goodness report, which basically states that they've planted 1 lakh trees, and other than that, they have recycled 1,135 metric tons of plastic. Just to give you a perspective, 1 metric ton is equal to 1,000 kgs. Other than that, keeping in mind the current situation, they've distributed 50,000 sanitizers and 20,000 cotton masks to our COVID heroes. I will say that this hair oil is very non-sticky, especially since it's summer. I like to avoid that chip feeling at all costs. After which I of course follow it up with my favorite onion shampoo. This has onion and plant keratin, and then of course we have the conditioner, which has onion and coconut in this. So this is the 3-step routine that I've been following for my hair. In case you want to use and buy these products for yourself, you can use my code MRIDUL2021 to get a 20% off on mamaearth.in. Other than that, all Mamaearth products are available on Amazon, Nykaa and Flipkart. Oh, by the way, Mamaearth has launched their app, so I'm going to be leaving both the Android and the iOS links in the description box below for you guys to download. If you want like extra discounts, I think that is the place to go, because you will get an early access at all the sales. Okay, so since I've already done my chumpy and hair wash yesterday, today I'm gonna be doing a face mask. So before that, let me just quickly remove my makeup. Okay, I'm back, and today I'm gonna be using this salicylic face mask that I showed in my favorites video. Actually, before that, I'm just gonna quickly remove my nails. So this is actually how easily my stick-on nails come off. So I've actually used these nail tabs I'll show you what they look like. And I use these nail tabs when I know I want the nails on just for like a day. And it doesn't have the best grip, but it's like perfect for like shoot days like today. Itna easily nikal jata hai. So this is actually the only nail which is not coming off because I stuck this with the glue. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna soak it in hot water and it'll pop off. But for now, I'm just gonna start applying the face mask. I'm just gonna leave it on for like 15-20 minutes. And then I think I'm also gonna grab dinner. And then uske baad I'll go for a quick shower. I'll show you my dinner actually. Perfumes honestly make me feel so nice. It's probably very petty and superficial. It does sound like that. I'm very aware of that. But it honestly does put me in a nice mood. So every morning when I'll take a shower, I'll apply it. And especially before I go to bed. So I've showered, as you can see, I'll apply a scent that makes me feel happy. Scents are supposed to make you feel kind of nostalgic and bring back memories from a specific time. So this is the one that I like to spray. This is by Victoria's Secret. It's their Pure Seduction. And this is what I used to use in college. And it just brings back so many happy, nice memories. Talking about perfumes, I do want to do kind of like a mini Nykaa haul. So this isn't stuff that I ordered right now. In fact, it's stuff that I ordered like a month ago. And it came in, I think, 2 weeks ago. But by that time, I was already here at my parents' place. So I got it, we fasted here. It's been sitting out for a while. So I just thought I would share everything. The first thing that I actually have to share isn't something that I bought, but it's something that Aditi gifted me. This is what it looks like. It's by YSL. And she also sent me the cutest note ever. How precious is that? Other than that, I purchased this perfume. So this is by Pure Excess, and this is something that Adya wears, and it smells so nice on her, so I had to pick it up. Other than that, I also picked up a concealer palette. So it comes with a bunch of different shades, so I can mix and kind of adjust to my skin tone, which is great. Uske alawa actually kuch bhi nahi liya maine, sirf perfume aur ye concealer palette liya tha. Aur ye free mein mujhe Nykaa ka pencil mil gaya, which is great. So yeah, that was my very mini Nykaa haul. So I was just working on Skion and a little bit on Simba, and that reminded me that this is definitely something that makes me feel excited for the future. And I do want to point out that it is specifically a hard time if you own a business, a small business. I know exactly what you're going through, but I feel like this is a great time for us to just kind of regroup and kind of plan for the future. This downtime, I don't think we'll ever get in general also, but especially for like businesses, it's just great to like be able to pre-plan, because again, as I said, ye time kabhi wapas nahi milega, itna free time. So that's just what we've been doing, working for like the future. Literally, I'm working for a product which is going to launch in like January 2022. So trying to like really pre-plan as much as we can. But I did want to share with you guys a few new launches. So by the time this video goes live, these two new colors are already live. So you guys might have already seen the Black Forest collection. I mentioned it briefly in my favorites video. By the way, if you buy a crop top and joggers, you will get a free mask. Now, onto the new launch. So this is Strawberry Crumble. If you haven't noticed already, we've like named all of our variants on the basis of like desserts. We already have a bodycon dress, but a lot of you guys actually requested that we do the same color in joggers and crop top. We also have a hoodie, by the way. So again, if you buy a crop top and joggers, you'll get a free mask. So this is a new launch, along with which we're launching a brand new color. Oops, I almost showed you a new product which is gonna launch, I don't know, probably in June. But yeah, this is what the new color looks like. This is called Fruit Cake. So this is basically a combination of pink, orange and yellow, and literally looks like a fruit cake. Pata hai wo cake hota tha jisme choti choti jelly hoti thi, aur usme yahi teen color ki jelly hoti thi. So I thought it would be perfect to name it Fruit Cake. And I think this is, I feel like I say this about all my collections, but this is my new favorite. It's my current fave. So this is what we've recently launched. In case you want to pick anything up, of course, I'm going to leave a link in the description box below. And I also do want to give a huge shout out to some of my YouTube friends, like specifically Gopali, That Quirky Miss, even Kritika Goel. They've been like buying stuff from Skion and Simba also actually, and they've been supporting my small business, which honestly means so much. I haven't sent out any PR packages. So if you see them posting about my products, they've actually bought it themselves. Even Anandita, actually. People are so nice. Like, honestly, they didn't need to buy anything from me. I would eventually send like PR packages, but they're just trying to support me, and it honestly brings a smile and makes my heart feel so warm. Not because of like the monetary aspect, but it's just the thought that matters. So yeah, that's what is up. So it is going to be 10:30 right now, and my alarm abhi any second bajega. So basically, I have 10:30 ka alarm laga ke rakha hai for me to be able to call my nanny. Otherwise, I just end up forgetting. So every night I have an alarm at 10:30. So I call her and I speak to my nana and nanny both. We all are going through so much, and if you have grandparents, please give them a call. I feel like they feel the most lonely at this point of time, and if you can just spare like 10-15 minutes out of your time, it would really make their day.
Hello.
Hi nana.
Hi bol, kem che?
Bas maja ma, su karo jo.
Karu kam thank you.
Ha pati ki maru kam.
Are wow.
That's so nice. It's usually one of my highlights of the day, just talking to my nana and nani. Another thing that's kind of related is video calling your friends. So we've actually decided, all of my friends and I have decided, Monday is the day when we video call together. All of us, like all six of us, have to be present on Monday. And aaj, I think 11:30 ko karne wale, to time hai abhi. Do that if you can, because it just, like, we just summarize our entire week and we just laugh and make silly jokes, and it's nice, you know. So that's definitely something that makes me happy. Hi, bol do ek bar union mein.
Hi guys.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. Arey, Siddhi ka awaaz nikla.
Okay. So I just took a quick break from video calling because I know wo 3-4 baje tak to chalne hi wala hai. So I just wanted to share one of the last things that I do that keep me sane and just keep my mental peace. It just really helps me stay calm mentally. So it is to have your kadha, or now these days I've just been having some hot water with haldi, and also I've been taking my vitamins. This is everything that I do towards the end of the day. And another thing that I really have been practicing seriously is steaming my face. I'll leave my steamer link down below. This is something that I started doing very religiously when I started staying at my nanny's place, because they do it every day. They try to. So I've been doing it with them, and this is what I'm gonna do, and I'll fetch you in just a second. So done with steaming. Of course, taking care of yourself is really, really important right now. Eat healthy, drink lots of fluids, ideally warmer fluids. So that's what I've been doing, and it just makes me feel mentally at peace that I'm taking care of myself. So I think that's basically it for today's vlog. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching today's vlog. I know this vlog is gonna be super lengthy, very long. I already know it. So let me know in the comments down below if you like these long videos, or should I stick to my usual 15-minute videos. And I think that's basically it. Stay safe, stay at home, and I'll see you very soon in my next video. Bye.